Area of circle equals pi times square of the radius of circle equals pi times square of diameter of the circle divided by 4. As we know that the radius of the circle equals half of the diameter of the circle. It is given that the radius of the circle equals 3 cm. Therefore, the area of this circle equals pi times 3 square, which results in 9 pi square centimeter. A sector of a circle is a region bounded by an arc and two radii. For example, the sector XOZ is bounded by an arc XYZ and two radii OX and OZ. When a segment of a circle is a region bounded by an arc and one chord. For example, the segment MEN is bounded by the chord MN and arc MEN. Area of a sector. The ratio of the area of a sector of a circle to the area of entire circle is equal to the degree measure of its arc to 360 degrees. If we consider the sector AOC, then the arc with respect to this sector is ABC, which has a measure of x equal 30 degrees, and the radius of this circle equals 3 cm. Therefore, the area of sector AOC equals 30 divided by 360 multiplies pi r square, or 30 divided by 360 multiplies pi times 3 square, where r equals 3 is the radius of this circle. So the area of the sector AOC equals 30 times pi multiplied by 3 square divided by 360, which results in 3 pi by 4 square centimeter. Tangent of a circle. A tangent to circle is the line that lies in the same plane as the circle and intersect the circle at exactly one point, called point of tangency. For example, for this circle, O is the center and D is the point of tangency for the tangent PT. If a line is tangent to a circle, then the radius drawn to the point of tangency is perpendicular to the tangent line. As OD is the radius drawn to the point of tangency D, that is why OD is perpendicular to PT, and so ODP equals angle ODT is equal to 90 degrees. For this circle, TP and SP are two tangents at the point of tangency T and S, and so OT is perpendicular to TP and OS is perpendicular to SP, and so angle T and angle S equal to 90 degrees. That is why triangle OSP is a right triangle, where we can apply the theorem of Pythagoras, and the opposite side of right angle is OP, which is equal to x plus 8, where x is the radius of the circle. And the radius r equals OS is equal to OQ is equal to OT. So OQ is equal to x as well. So applying the theorem of Pythagoras, we can get that x is equal to 5 cm. And that is why the area of this circle equals pi times 5 square, which equals 25 pi square centimeter. So the quantity A equals 25 pi, and it is given that quantity B is equal to 25 pi as well. So the correct answer is choice C, which states that the two quantities are equal to each other. Angle formed by a tangent and chord on the circle. An angle formed by an intersecting tangent and chord has its vertex on the circle, the vertex T. So for the tangent T2T1 and chord PT, the intersecting angle PTT1 will have a measure of half of the measure of the intercepted arc. For the chord PT and tangent T2T1, the intercepted arc is PQT with endpoints P and T, which has a measure of 120 degree. PTT1 has a measure of half of 120 degree, which equals 60 degree. Again, the alternate segment theorem states that the angle between a tangent and chord is equal to the angle made by that chord in the alternate segment. So the chord PT creates the angle PXT in the alternate segment. That is why PTT1 equals 60 degree is equal to PXT, which is also is equal to 60 degree according to the hypothesis of alternate segment theorem. Angle formed by a tangent and a secant or chord outside the circle. Measure of angle formed by a tangent and a secant or chord outside the circle equals half multiplies the difference of intercepted arcs. For example, for this circle, the chord XM or secant XY and the tangent ZY creates an angle Y outside the circle, and the intercepted arcs are MEN and XAN, where XAN has a measure of 210 degree. And if we consider the circle as an arc, then it will have a measure of 360 degree, which is equal to the measure of arc XAN plus the measure of arcs NEM plus the measure of arc MTX, where the measure of arc MTX is equal to 50 degree. Therefore, the measure of arc NEM or MEN is equal to 100 degree. Therefore, the measure of angle Y outside the circle formed by the tangent and the secant or chord is equal to half multiplies 210 minus 100 degree, which equals half of 110 degree, which results in 55 degree. Angles formed by two tangents or angle formed outside the circle by intersection. Measure of angle formed by two tangents equal to half multiplies difference of intercepted arcs. For this circle, we can write that 360 degree is equal to measure of arc TRS plus measure of arc TDS. Here it is given that the measure of arc, the intercepted arc by the two tangent TP and SP is 120 degree. Therefore, the measure of arc, the measure arc TDS at the point endpoint T and S created by the two tangent TP and SP is equal to 240 degree. Therefore, the measure of angle formed by two tangents TP and SP equals half multiplies 240 degree minus 120 degree, which results in 60 degree. Therefore, angle P equals 60 degree. Thanks for watching. Perceive, persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from Higher Study Prep.